Hi, I'm back, and we're going to answer the question, why is it that someone could potentially have high blood sugar in the morning when they're absolutely eating no sugar whatsoever? That's very, very weird. And sometimes when a person then eats their first meal, their sugar comes down. So what's going on with that? Well, actually, this is what's happening. Your liver is making the sugar. And the name for that is called gluconeogenesis. Genesis means make, neo means new, gluco means sugar. So the liver is making new sugar out of either protein or ketones or fat. Another term for that is called de novo synthesis of glucose. So your body is making it without it coming from the diet. Now the question is, why does that occur? Now, just so you know, a little bit of that is a normal body response. In other words, everyone has a little bit of this going on due to several hormone fluctuations that occur as a circadian wave throughout the night and the day. So it involves growth hormone, adrenaline, and cortisol. And to a very small degree, you're going to have blood sugar fluctuations through the night and through the day. And when you have too much of that, it's called the dawn phenomena, where you wake up and your blood sugar is too high. That's because you have insulin resistance. Insulin resistance makes this condition a lot worse. It exaggerates the condition where you're waking up and your blood glucose is 120. And it really has to do with insulin. Insulin is a hormone that stores fat. It's also supposed to block this from happening right here. When you have insulin resistance, you're not absorbing insulin in the cells. So in certain places of your body, you don't have enough insulin. In other places, you have too much. So this really is an insulin deficiency because insulin is supposed to suppress the production of glucose. All right, that being said, let's just talk about normal blood sugars. Normally, you should have a blood sugar of about 80. Now, what does that mean? That means that if we take all of your blood in your body, the amount of sugar that would be dissolved in all of your blood, if you had your blood sugars about 80, would be 1 level teaspoon of sugar, 5 grams of sugar. For every 10 points that your blood sugar goes up from 80 to a 90, that's an increase of 0.5 gram. So when your blood sugar is 120, that means you have an extra 2 grams of sugar in all of your blood. It's not an outrageous amount of sugar. So this would be a little less than 0.5 teaspoon of sugar. So right there, you should know that this is not a serious situation and you're not going to start to create a lot of problems throughout the body because your body is making it. There's an imbalance. How can we correct this? Number one, you just have to realize that it's going to take more time, okay? You have insulin resistance, so just keep doing what you're doing and give it more time. And I'm talking about doing keto and intermittent fasting by the book. And over time, you'll see it'll get better and better and better. You could also take things to speed up the process, like potassium, magnesium, zinc, and vitamin B12. All of these will help you speed up the resolution of insulin resistance. And the last thing you can do, and you can do this in the morning when you wake up, is you can go for a nice walk. Walking for about 20 minutes should easily burn off this extra sugar. You can do other workouts as well. All right, thanks for watching.
Hey, we're back.
With another amazing recipe.
No grains, no sugar, totally keto. There's no suffering in keto.
Absolutely not, Karen.
And it's an immune system builder.
Absolutely. You have to check this out.
I think you should hurry up, watch the recipe, and make it yourself. It's just so easy to be keto.
But is it simple?
It's super simple. We hope you enjoy making it as much as we are enjoying eating it.